not by a group of independent experts trying to figure out how to test for true safety. He went public with his concerns and was a hero for 2 days at his institute. And then 2 phone calls were placed by the UK Prime Minister's office, forwarded through the receptionist to the director of the institute. The next day, he was fired from his job after 35 years and silenced with threats of a lawsuit. They never implemented his protocols into the EU assessment process. Instead, they attacked him and destroyed his reputation. But on February 16th, 1999, the gag order was lifted. 159 column feet of articles were written in a week. One editor said it divided society into 2 warring blocks. 750 articles were written in a month. And in 10 weeks, the tipping point of consumer rejection was achieved. What do I mean by the tipping point of consumer rejection? It means that the numbers of that you just rated yourself got high enough in Europe so that using GM ingredients became a marketing liability. And Unilever publicly committed to stop using GM ingredients in Europe, and by the end of the week, so did virtually everyone else. It took 1 week for people, for the plan to replace nature to evaporate. Because when Europe stopped GMOs, so did Africa, because they sold stuff to Europe. Everything slowed way down. And it was not the government that did it. It was consumers raising their hands saying, my number is higher. I now don't want to eat GMOs. And the food companies saying, ah, I see the hands. So they give us, actually, a formula for how to end the genetic engineering of the food supply. It took 10 minutes to change many people's diets. Usually I take 45 minutes or an hour and 15, or a book or a movie or whatnot. But it's the same thing anywhere in North America. I rate people before and after on a scale of 1 to 100, and virtually everyone shifts. So we know what
could be your pancreas, it could be your brain, it could be your any gland in the body, and a little child born. And now, the latest, anyway, I'm not going to go into detail, I think I'll leave that for tomorrow's discussion, how these corporations are saying mothers should not be now giving milk to the babies because their mother's antibody is interfering with the vaccine. Mother's antibody is interfering with the vaccine. And that antibody is the maximum in India. So they're telling Indian mothers not to do so.